Yeah. They gon' feel this shit.
They fix just trying to make some bad. Got people hating on me. I'm on my way to the top. I promise I ain't falling off until the day my heart stops. They say I'm cutting up too much. It's like I own a barber shop. Got too much drip up in my whips. My driveway, a parking lot. Got people hating on me. I'm on my way to the top. I promise I ain't falling off until the day my heart stops. They say I'm cutting up too much. It's like I own a barber shop. Got too much drip up in my whips.
Alright, what's good, YouTube? We back with another video. It's your boy, Real Fucking Kid. I'm bullshitting. Anyways, we back with another video. Make sure y'all like the video. Make sure y'all comment. Make sure y'all share. Make sure y'all send it to your grandma and your aunties and your cousins and all that. Because they at the crib right now. We ain't doing shit. So, it's story time. Quarantine day number. I don't know what day it is, but we been in the crib. So, anyways, back with us. So, today's story. It's about a gold digger, LA gold digger, is what we gonna call it, you feel? So y'all know I went to LA like 2 months ago? January, I went to LA. Me and my brother, we was out there, y'all know, having a good time, yada, yada, yada. So we ran the court vet. We was in that motherfucker's work, you feel? So we had the vet. Let me tell you how this went. So my brother like, man, we gotta go out, we gotta go to the city, see what it's like, yada, yada, yada. I'm like, cool, let's go to the city. So we go down there, we take the top off, doing it, you know what I'm saying? We swerving on him, you feel me, you know what I'm saying? Anyways, I call my boy, my homeboy. I'm like, hey, what's a spot in LA to go to? He said, Hollywood Boulevard. Mind you, we never been to LA, so we don't know. So we go Hollywood Boulevard. I ain't gonna lie to you, that motherfucker was, but hold on, that boy look a little rough, hold on. Anyway, back to the story. So yeah, he was like, go to Hollywood Boulevard. I'm like, cool, we go to Hollywood Boulevard. So it's about 2 a.m, my brother like, man, I need some liquor. But he googled a liquor store. We pull over to some store on this, like, round this corner. It's not even on Hollywood Boulevard. You would think it would be on Hollywood Boulevard, but it's in, like, their neighborhood or whatever. So we go there. I already knew this man went in the store. I knew he was going to come out with it. Bro bought a bottle of Henny. So I'm like, I already know. I already know where this story going. So I'm like, all right, bro, finna drink this Henny. Anything finna happen tonight. So he drink the Henny. We get on back on Hollywood Boulevard. He driving, and he see two girls walking down the street. At this point, it's like 3, almost 4. I'm like, girl, we finna go to the crib. Nah. Pull over, there's two girls right there. I'm like, bro, tweaking. Like, we not finna talk to these goofy assholes walking down the street. And it's 3, 4 in the morning. You know what I'm saying? Like, who finna talk to these buses on the street? So he being thirsty at this point. So I'm like, all right, cool, whatever. Let's pull over. We pull over. We got the top off. You know, we in the vet. So it's going up already, you feel me? Busting. So we pull over. He like, man, I ain't come all the way from Chicago not to get no pussy. I'm like, I guess, whatever, you know what I'm saying? You whatever, cool. So he hop out, and the girl must have heard him, so they laughing already as we pull up. They already going. He's talking to the friend. I'm sitting there, I'm chilling. It's another girl, but I ain't want to talk to her, so I'm like, I already know this bitch finna go because we got the car, so I ain't even want to talk to her. So come find out, shorty looking at me, waiting for me to say something. I'm like, shorty, I ain't really not even thinking about her, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, all right, cool, whatever. So she walk up to the car. She, what's your name? Tell her my name. I'm like, yeah, we ain't from out here. Like, we only here for the weekend type shit. We ain't just trying to find something to get into, yada, yada, yada. She's, oh, well, give me your number, blah, blah, blah. Red flag. I'm gonna tell you why it's a red flag. Don't no girl just be like, I mean, there's some girls that do it, don't get me wrong. But don't no girl really just be like, give me your number. So I gave her the number. I'm like, cool, you know what I'm saying? Whatever, hit me up tomorrow, whatever, yada, yada. We leave. Shorty hit me up as I'm driving to the crib. Mind you, like I said, it's about 3, 4 in the morning. She hit me up as we driving to the crib. Red flag. But then I read the message. I took back the red flag because she said, man, let me know when you get home safely. Kissy face. I'm like, all right, I ain't used to this because Chicago girls ain't like this, you know what I'm saying? Chicago girls, these motherfuckers, they some thugs, you know, these motherfuckers. Don't text me shit, bitch. We text them when they get home. We make sure they get to the crib, you feel me? So, whatever. Anyways, so she texts me, like, make sure you let me know when you get home, yada, yada, yada. I'm like, all right, cool. Red flag, should have known. So, I tell her when I get home, she geeked. She's like, okay, it was nice meeting you, boo. Another kissy face. Oh, nice meeting you too, blah, blah, blah. Hit me up tomorrow. Check it. So, anybody that know me know I go to sleep, and I be sleep till like 2, 3 in the afternoon. Why should they call me at 9 a.m.? Red flag. I'm looking like, is this for real? So I answer the phone. What's up? I'm fresh out the bed, you know. What's up? She, what you up to? I'm just seeing what you're doing, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, I just woke up. Like, girl, you realize 9 o'clock in the morning? She, I'm out running around. I'm gonna go to this place. Yada, yada. All right, cool. Whatever. So I go downstairs. My brother already in the kitchen cooking. I'm like, bro, who that on the phone? This is the girl from last night. Mind you, this man probably talks like 5 different girls, so he don't know who he talking about. He just like, tell her I said what's up, yeah. And I told him who it was. And he's like, tell her friend, you know, to add me back on Snapchat. I'm like, okay, tell your friend add my brother back. You feel me? She ain't gonna do that. So we chilling on the phone, we talking. Next thing I know, she's like, how long y'all here? Whatever, yada, yada. We get to the conversation of how long we staying, what we doing tonight, whatever, yada, yada. Cool. She's like, you got an Instagram? So I'm like, yeah. In my head, I'm like, nah, you finna give me my Instagram, you feel me? I had to ask her this question first. So I asked her, how many Instagram followers you got? She gonna tell me. I'm like, 4,000. I'm like, I don't follow nobody that got over like 1,200 followers, you feel me? How many people you follow? So I asked her, she like, I follow like 100 and something, red flag. I'm like, okay, so she IG model wanna be, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, all right, red flag, whatever. She like, yeah, why? How many you got? I'm only got like 900. She only got like 900, I ain't cap, you feel me? So she follow me, I follow back. We on the phone, she like, she go up through my Instagram. I'm going through hers while we on the phone at this point. She, what kind of car you drive? Red flag. What the hell they got to do with anything? I got a Q50, you feel me? My Q50 nasty, mind you. I'm like, I got a Q50. What they got on the dash? Got like 180. Why? What's your car got on the dash? She look. It's a 200 on the dash, she said. She said, I got 200. What you got? I drive a BMW, mind you. Last night when I seen her, I forgot to tell you this part. She was at like next to a Chevy Cruze. I know the seats in a Chevy Cruze. A couple of my friends got Chevy Cruzes. So I look at the seat, I'm like, she capping. She definitely in like a Chevy Cruze, but I ain't saying nothing. So I'm like, all right, cool, whatever. So then I'm like, all right, cool. She's like, let me hit you back. I'm about to go in this place real quick and I'll call you after. I'm like, okay, cool, whatever. I don't know this girl, so do your thing. Hour or two go by, I'm like, all right, cool. She ain't texting me, she ain't calling me. I'm like, she ain't been in that place that damn long. But take you this same time, I'm like, I don't know her life. So I'm like, all right, cool. I text her, what you up to? No response, right? I go on her Instagram. I keep scrolling. I find out, shorty in the car, like a Rolls Royce in one picture. You know, bitches got flex. They put the shoulder, you know what I'm saying? The shoulder RR on the seat. So I'm like, okay, cool. Go to another picture, I see a Lambo. She a model? No, mind you, swear you're real. So I'm like, okay, so it ain't click to me that she asked me the type of car I drive. Well, it did click to me, but like, I ain't think she was like that. Hour go by, she unfollowed me. I text her again, like, what, you not fuck with me or something? No response. So I add her on Snapchat, right? Alternative. Her Snapchat's open. I see this bitch in a Lamborghini on Snapchat, right? Some nigga was on her Snapchat. No, she was in the passenger seat. Some nigga was driving. And I'm like, okay, cool. That's how this bitch live her life, whatever. I go later on. He posted it. I don't know this dude, but she posted it on her story later on. This dude posts, I'm missing my baby in the passenger seat. So I guess he dropped her off, right? Red flag. So this bitch and niggas with nice cars, right? So this is how I find out the bitch a gold digger. So I'm like, So I keep going through the Instagram and I see like all the people she follow, people that drive like Lambos and Rolls Royces and shit. One of these bitches, right? Mind you, Shorty was not that. Like, Shorty was average. If I can find her Instagram, I'll put it in this video, but I can't. So come find out. Yeah, Shorty ain't never take me back. Shorty ain't do nothing. She found out what I drive. Try to play me. You feel me? So I'm cool. See, that's why I told you I would talk to the girl. I ain't gonna lie to you. It did blow me. But you live and you learn, right? So that's the story. So wait for her. Anyways, I'm gonna start making some more story time, so make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe. This the LA Gold Digger that happened to me. You feel me? I know some of y'all done got some gold digger stories. Why y'all get y'all ass on the camera and tell them damn stories? We go.
Hey, can't believe you tried it, bitch, you played. Wanted a diamond choke as soon as her time was over. Bitch, you played. She wanna ride the Rover. Told her Uber was closer. Bitch, you crazy. She tried to show out in public. I cut the bitch out like it's nothing. Bitch, you played.